Hi students, welcome to the course on cyber security. Myself, Dr. A. Murli M.Rao, head of IT department, Indira Gandhi National Open University, New Delhi. So this session I would like to talk on emerging threats and security technologies. It means that emerging threats and emerging security technologies. Let's see that what is a security breach. A security breach is any incident that results in unauthorized access of data, applications, services, networks, and our devices bypassing their underlying security mechanisms. A security breach occurs when an individual or an application illegitimately enters a private, confidential, or unauthorized logical IT perimeter. Security breach is also known as a security violation. See that the biggest question is that how do we know there will be a security breach or threat? See, for example, if it is a physical, in the context of physical security, we know that so some physical item is not visible, easily it can be traced out and know that something is missing or something has happened. But in cyber security or in a cyber world, it is very difficult to know that something is missing unless the damage happened, unless the total the IC system got failed or defunct. That's why it is a very challenging task to know that whether there will be a security breach or not. That's why, so I would like to stress on how do we know that there will be a security breach or threat. Violation in any of the following security services or parameters leads a security breach. One is the authentication, confidentiality, integrity, authorization, access control, and non-repudiation. We call these six parameters or the six security parameters are the critical parameters for successful functioning of an IT system in a networked environment. See, what will happen if there is a security breach or a threat? See, hackers will take an advantage of it for what? To intrude into organization's network, get access to the servers, systems, applications, and databases, steal and or delete the sensitive data for sake of fun or the business discontinuity or business loss. Deface websites or the defacing of web portals. Inject viruses, trojans and many more to damage. See, before going to that, let's find out that what will be the threat landscape. It means that where the hackers or attackers will use the space to start the hacking the things, to initiate some kind of hacking or attacking. Broadly, the threat landscape, we can categorize the landscape. One is the software based, hardware based, and the people. Suppose, see, if it is software based, what is the landscape, the threat landscape? Through viruses, worms, spyware, rootkits, exploit scripts, protocol exploits, and so on. If it is hardware based, again there are hardware trojans, counterfeit components, it means that the fake components. And if you talk about the people, so insider or the outsider threats, either from malicious or inadvertent action or interaction. apart from the normal things now, because of by introducing so many areas of IT functioning, that's why the threat landscape is exponentially changing. Students, let's see the changing threat landscape. So one of the changing threat landscape is due to IoT and mobility, online financial transactions, usage of more smart devices, social media, growing 5G deployment and adoption, increasing digitization, increasing outsourcing, and also increasing interconnectedness. So these are all the newly upcoming areas and where the functionalities are tremendously useful, but at the same time these activities or these functionalities are again giving a scope for changing or increasing the threat landscape. Let's see that the IoT and mobility. See, students, so IoT, the Internet of Things, the goal behind IoT is that connect all smart devices and share the resources or the information together in form of some network, correct? So connecting all smart devices and sharing the information over a closed network. That is where the basic theme or goal behind Internet of Things, and that in mobility. So, some devices in IoT, some devices would be stationary, but some other devices would be in motion or in mobility. So, because of this, again, the threat landscape is increasing. See, for example, one small application of IoT. See, for example, see that a smart home. Smart home means that, again, it is based on the IoT. Smart home means that, again, it is some kind of a living house or a home where the appliances used in the home or a house are always having or almost having a smartness. Say, for example, say your air conditioning, which has a smart device where it will through which the signals will be passed through and can be able to control. Suppose, see, even for our the refrigerator, or even the lighting also, everything has a small piece of device where it is connected and it will pass the signals to over a network, whether the network would be either through internet or a Wi-Fi or even mobile telecommunications network to a mobile or any other smart device. See, even for example, see a CCTV camera, if it is installed in front of the house, so it will capture the total video and pass on to whoever we want. So in such case, some devices are in stationary and some other are in mobility, so that information will be transferred or shared for controlling the devices. See, for example, as I told you that, if it is a IoT application in a smart home, means that whatever appliances we are using in a smart home are able to talk each other, share each other over a network and pass the thing to any smart device, could be a mobile phone or maybe even any other smart device. So because of this type of applications, again the attack or the threat landscape is again increasing, so that each device has a separate security policy, otherwise very difficult to have a uniform security policy to be implemented or to be enforced to control securely all the devices connected using this IoT technologies. Similarly, now see the second area. See, online financial transaction. Nowadays, almost 75 to 80% of financial transactions are through online. Again, the threat landscape is again increasing. See, online financial transaction could be a banking transaction or even some online e-shopping, e-business, all commercial things. Now, the financial transactions are happening online. Again, in such case, again, but once the functionality-wise, the online financial transactions are very good, so that wherever we are, we can perform some financial transaction, whether it will be depositing money or transferring the money or even to buy some goods online by performing some financial transactions through a debit card or a credit card or internet banking. But here again, this is at a positive front. But again, this facility, this feature, again creating, again increasing the threat landscape, where the attackers or hackers again play a vital role to compromise such devices or maybe steal the confidential data. Similarly, the usage of more smart devices. Another is that nowadays most of the devices have some smartness. It means that's why we're calling it as smart devices. Means that smart devices are intelligent devices. By using more smart devices in various areas, in various application areas, again such smart devices again are increasing and the threat landscape. See, for example, say a mobile phone or take any other devices. So even see the wearable technologies, all these are all comes under smart devices, but at same time, which one is the positive side is its applications, but the other hand, again, they are creating some space to the attackers or hackers to do something mischievous things. And another is that the social media, which is also another important area and fast-growing area where most of the people are get connected through social media, whether it could be a Facebook or a Twitter, or if you take even a WhatsApp, all even LinkedIn, all these social media where the millions of users are sharing their information, sometimes even the confidential data or even the sensitive data across each other. Again, social media, again area, again increasing the threat landscape. Now another is that the growing 5G deployment and adoption. Once the 5G is, of course, in some developed countries already 5G services are available. Now even the country like India, so if the 5G is deployed, then again it again gives a scope and increase the threat landscape for many things to do by hackers are the attackers. The other is that digitization. So again, due to the rapid digitization activity, again the threat landscape is again increasing. The other is outsourcing also, increasing of outsourcing. Now mostly, most of the areas, most of the departments, for most of the activities, so outsourcing is right now going on. Because of that also, because of lot of heterogeneity, so again there will be a scope for again increase in threat landscape. And another important thing is that increasing interconnectedness. This is another challenging issue. One is that the interoperability or interconnectedness, the enormous applications are there. It means that connecting or sharing the information among various devices, various smart devices. So that is good, but at same time, that is also creating the threat change of the threat landscape. It means that, see, the digital information sharing increasing between federal, state, local governments and corporations, and the number of endpoint devices, for example, say PCs, laptops, smartphones, smart meters, wearable devices, medical devices, sensors, supervisory controls, etc., accessing or attached to the networks is again rising. Because of this, so the threat landscape is again changing into a new dimension, and which is protecting them is also a big challenging task to control all the devices, to provide security among all devices, to see that all devices functioning and the resources of those devices should not get hacked or defaced by hackers or attackers. So these are all the changing threat landscape. So for that, automatically there are many new attacks are again coming up by hackers due to this increase in threat landscape. Student, let's see that what are various security challenges. Maintain security posture with the changing business model and attack vectors, because as we all know that totally the business models are changing. Everything on demand service, wherever we are, irrespective of time, irrespective of place, see that to perform some kind of business through the smart devices. Again, maintaining security a poster with this kind of a changing business model really, and also the attack vectors, this is a big challenging security challenge, one of the security challenges. Similarly, continuously protecting across dynamic threat landscape. See that, because the more connected devices of multiple functionalities connecting each other, sharing the information each other, continuously protecting such devices in a dynamic threat landscape is also a very, very challenging issue. And another is that reducing complexity and fragmentation of security solutions is also one of the security challenges. See, students, earlier very few devices are there. It is easy to have some unified security solution to control all these things and to provide security. But nowadays, because of many heterogeneous smart devices connecting each other, sharing each other, because of that, it is very difficult, because the work domain is totally different. It is very difficult a single security solution to secure all such devices. Because of that, what is happening is that each security device, each device is again have its own security policy, security control to control the device. But when you see that as a whole, what will happen? Suppose in case of IoT environment, number of devices, each device has its own security policy. It is very difficult to have a unified security policies to secure all the devices connected in IoT environment. Because of that, automatically we are reducing the complexity, and the security is also fragmented, more or less like a device dependent security policy than device independent security policy. So because of this, again, the reducing complexity and the fragmentation of security solution is also a big challenge to secure the environment. So student, these are all some of the security challenges by keeping the change in threat landscape in mind. Let's talk about by keeping the changing landscape. Now, new attacks, new threats are also coming up. Some of the emerging threats are hardware trojans, ransomware, social engineering, identity theft, artificial intelligence generated phishing emails, say we call it as AI generated phishing mails, cryptojacking, attacking from the computing cloud, mobile malware, hacking, AI defense with again AI tools. These are all some of the emerging threats due to the increase or change threat landscape. Students, I would like to just touch upon the details about each emerging threats. Suppose see the hardware Trojan. We all know that about the software Trojan. Software Trojan is some kind of a small malicious software application, a small piece of software which will be resided in a computer. Then whenever the system or a computer laptop got rebooted or restarted, so that small piece of that malicious software start working and do the damage to the system. But that is somehow can be detected and can be controlled. But now the biggest challenging is on hardware Trojans are coming up, which is a very, very serious for especially the electronic industry. Hardware Trojans are undesired, malicious, intentional modifications to the electronic circuits. It means that it will be done at a circuit level, which means that the hardware Trojan will be embedded with electronic circuit. It is very, very difficult even to trace out that there will be an electronic circuit. See, for example, just one small example, I will explain what is the hardware Trojan. See, for example, we have, suppose you have bought a television, I assume that. See, for example, the warranty, the company gives the warranty as a 3 years. After that, there is no warranty. Suppose if there is some kind of hardware Trojan, if that company embedded, it means that it will embed in a circuit in such way that after 3 years, malfaced circuit won't function. Only it will start functioning after 3 years. It means that suppose if our warranty period is over, then it will start functioning. Then immediately it will defunction. It will the functioning of the television will be automatically stopped or misbehave. Really, see, it is very, very difficult to trace, to identify whether an electronic appliance is having hardware Trojan or not. Of course, now testing tools also will come, but as on date now it is not available, but maybe in the near future some kind of hardware Trojan detecting software or tools will be available in the market. Otherwise, the hardware Trojan really it is a very, very challenging, especially to an electronic industry. Why? Because it is very difficult to trace, because the devices functions successfully up to the period of warranty period, whether it is 1 year or 3 years or 5 years. But after that, if that hardware Trojan is enforced or embedded within the circuit, say that it starts functioning its malicious activity after warranty period is over, so then it is very, very challenging. So the hardware Trojans are now the upcoming emerging threats. It is designed, the hardware Trojans designed to compromise the behavior of systems containing the circuits, presenting a persistent threat to their correct operations. The hardware Trojan can be inserted into an electronic circuit at any stage of design and development, or maybe manufacturing, distribution or maintenance. See, this is about hardware Trojan. It is one of the emerging threats due to the increase of the threat landscape. And see that the other is that ransomware. Students, we all see that the last year, even the lakhs of students, even lakhs of computers, even in the last year also got defunct due to ransomware. So ransomware is a type of malicious software designed to block access to a computer system until a sum of money is paid. We all seen that, you know, WannaCry. It encrypts over almost 176 file types, including databases, multimedia and archive files. So the last year, most of the organizations faced this WannaCry cry problem. And again, there is a PuTTY is also there. Again, it encrypts systems files, overrides its master's boot record, and then users out with a blue screen of death. And another, the part of again the category under ransomware is locking. It is also which encrypts over 130 file types, including those on removable devices or drives and unmapped network shares. These are all some of the things, comes under ransomware. This is also one of the emerging threats. Another is that we all know that social engineering. Social engineering is a method of deceiving people into giving you their information or exploiting their weakness or laziness to find that information. And it is believed to be the most frequently used method to get into a corporation's network these days. So social engineering is also one of the emerging threats. One has to be very, very careful with all these emerging threats. Students, another is emerging threat is identity theft. Identity theft is the crime of using someone's personal information, credit history, or other identifying characteristics in order to make purchases or borrow money without that person's permission. Really, identity theft means that stealing the identity of a person and claiming that a person is a original. Really, nowadays, the identity theft is also one of the emerging threats one has to be taken care. And similarly, another is that AI-generated phishing emails, that is artificial intelligence generated phishing email. Earlier, there is no such, mostly it is a manually or some static generating some phishing mail, asking some kind of sending us some mail saying that you got a lottery of this much, you got this, you got that. But it is very, but nowadays, so nowadays the people are well aware of such phishing mail. That's why now the hackers are using AI techniques, artificial intelligence techniques, again for generation of phishing emails. See, for example, human-generated phishing attack involve digital messages to trick people into clicking on a malicious link that installs malware or exposes sensitive data. AI-generated phishing emails are way more dangerous than the ones generated by humans. The earlier phishing emails are not that much, but nowadays, if the hackers are using AI techniques again to generate some phishing emails, now hackers are able to create highly realistic deep fake video and audio to fool individuals. See, deep fake means that, so it means that using the AI technique, able to give you some true information up to 2-3 level, and then further level may be a fake. Then so that the users may feel that might be it would be a genuine mail. Once we click on that, definitely whatever that mail intended will do damage. So AI-generated phishing email is also another emerging threat due to the increasing the attack landscape. Students, the another emerging threat is cryptojacking. It is also another type of upcoming or emerging threat. Cryptojacking is a form of cyber attack in which the attacker hijacks the third party computer or a tablet or a mobile phone or a connected home device to mine cryptocurrency. And bad actors use a malicious link or infect websites or online ads with JavaScript code that launch the crypto mining code in the victim's system. Really, this is also another dangerous emerging threat. And see, we just have some kind of wrapping that some worse security breaches happened in recent past. The Facebook data breach. The Cambridge Analytic scandal shook the world in March 2018, where personal data of almost 87 million Facebook users were compromised. See, this is the recent security breach has happened, worst security breach. And see, the British Airways hack also. Again, in recent past, a large scale hack on British Airways website and mobile app left personal information of almost to how much? This is 380,000 British passengers exposed. And the Quora breach is the most popular question answer site. Quora suffered a massive data breach where sensitive information of over 100 million users were compromised. These are all some of the worst security breaches happened in recent past. These are all happening due to the changing threat landscape. Now I would like to talk on some emerging security technologies apart from the traditional security technologies like some firewall, IDS, IPS, antivirus. So instead of that, so again due to the emerging threats, again so some emerging security technologies also required are needed to protect, to prevent those emerging threats. Correct. And seeing that, it is just like, you know, security means that always fight between a police and thieves, like a system administrator or a network administrator versus a hackers or a attackers. So like that, as the attack threat landscape is increasing, at the same time emerging threats also increasing. If emerging threats are increasing, again some emerging security technologies are required to protect, to prevent such things and further. So some of the emerging security technologies are, say, blockchain technology, deception technology, hardware authentication, user behavior analytics, deep learning, automation and adaptive network, and biometric. These are all some of the emerging security technologies to protect, to prevent from the emerging threats what I discussed just earlier. I would like to give a precise details on all these emerging security technologies. See, the blockchain, it is the upcoming emerging security technology. The blockchain is a way for one internet user to transfer a unique piece of digital property to another internet user, such that the transfer is guaranteed to be safe and secure. See, for example, in general ordinary sense, it is a big question mark that once we have sent something, so the receiver may say or may not say, there is no guarantee that it will be received. But now the blockchain technology definitely ensures that the safe and the secure transfer. Everyone knows that the transfer has taken place and nobody can challenge the legitimacy of the transfer. The consequences of this breakthrough are hard to overlast. And some of the things are, it is a continuously growing list of records, like a electronic ledger in form of a blocks. Blocks are linked source using cryptography. The block contains a hash pointer linked to the previous block. It has a timestamp, it has a transaction data. The blockchain for a shared ledger, smart contract, privacy validation. The first application using blockchain is the Bitcoin. The technologies used in blockchain are private cryptography, P2P networking, and the program, which is the blockchain's protocol. The second emerging security technology is a deception technology. It enables a more proactive security posture by seeking to deceive the attackers, detect them, and then defeat them, allowing the enterprise to return to a normal operations. See, it is just like some kind of, you know, honeypots kind of thing, the deception technology, where to provoke the hackers to come in so that their identity can be identified. The deception tools are automated, accurate, and provide insight into malicious activity within internal networks, which may be unseen by other types of cyber defense. Students, the another emerging security technology is a hardware authentication. So far, we all have seen that software authentication in form of some username, password, or maybe multi-level authentication like OTP, so on. But now the hardware authentication is also essentially needed, which is another emerging security technologies. The hardware authentication is an approach to user authentication that relies on a dedicated physical device, generally we call it as a token, held by an authorized user in addition to a basic password and to grant access to computer resources. The required devices generate a unique and temporary cryptographic code that must be input by the user in addition to the password to gain access to a computer resource. And another is also their user behavior analytics. The technology uses the big data analytics to identify anomalous behavior by a user. It is mostly suppose in a social networking, so huge volume of data being transferred, shared, it is very, very difficult to do some analytics. But the big data, with the help of the big data analytics approach, again user behavior will be so analyzed. And another is that the deep learning. The deep learning means that it is the deep learning encompasses a number of technologies using, such as the artificial intelligence and machine learning technologies and tools will be used in deep learning to detect unusual any incident, even at any level, at any bit, irrespective of huge volume of data. So with the help of this deep learning, so it is easy, can be detected any in the malified things, if any. Let's just see that I would like to stress upon data security standards or frameworks. See, what we have to do, that we have to pick up some standards from ISO 27000, NIST, that is a National Institute of Standards and Technologies, COBIT, SAN, and the Payment Card Industry Data Security Standard. These are all some of the standards where we have to use them to get the required things. Build and maintain a secure network. Protect cardholder data. Maintain a vulnerability management program. Implement a strong access control measures. Regularly monitor and test new networks. Maintain an information security policy. These are all some of the data security standards should be followed, should be framed and in place to have a secure networked environment. Students, just I would like to wrap up that this talk on emerging threats and the emerging security technologies. Just I spoke about that, what are the increasing or changing landscape, why the landscape is increasing, and then I have given that what are various emerging threats, and again followed by some emerging security technologies. See, with this, I would like to conclude that the session as maintaining security posture with changing business model and attack vector is a big challenge to continuously protecting the digital resources. However, the emerging security technologies shall always protect and prevent the changing threat landscape. Security is a process based but not product based. Dear students, I hope you all enjoyed this session. Hope it might be enlighten you in the area of the emerging threats and the emerging security technologies. With this, I will conclude. Thanks for listening. Thank you.